Good morning, friends. Again, today we'll try to learn about the project management concept. It is again the part of the unit 5. I think before we introduce the project management concept, I think you all know what is the meaning of the project. What is the project? You all are making the minor project and the major project in the 7th and 8th semester. What does the project mean to you all? Basically, project is the work assigned to you by your teachers. Means, in this work, it is just not a practical file preparation. You are doing some type of a, you are making some sort of a big program in software company. Since we are related to the computer science department, and you are working really in computer science. So basically your work is to develop some software, or to develop some website, or to develop some app, or to develop some IoT based work. Since we have seen that some of the students have made a project on IoT based, they are making some IoT device for agriculture. This is the project. This project means which involves number of counts in the software, means the line of counts are in much. So now project, so you are how to manage the project. This is the main concept of the behind this project management concept. Now this project management concept involves basically 4 P's. Means effective software has a 4 P's. Means when you are working in the project, the main role is of the 4 P's. The 4 P's are the people. The people means the person involved in the project. Second, the product. What product means? What project you are working or what product you are preparing. Third, the process. Process means how you are following the process or how will you do that work. And last is the project that is completed or not. Now let us understand what is the meaning of a people here. For a project, in a study it is found that the success of a software development organization is very much associated with the recruitment of a good people. Means if a good people are working in a company, or good people are working on a project, then there are the chances of success of the project. Otherwise, the project may fail. Now, what is the meaning of good people here? The good people may be the stakeholder. The stakeholder means the senior manager, the project technical manager, the practitioner, the customer, and the end user who will be working on it. Good people may be a team leader that has the capability to motivate, organize, innovate, have the problem-solving attitude, have the influencing power, and have a guts to make a big team. Means he is a team leader of 8 to 10 person, or it might be a 4 to 5 person. Means he has to handle more than 2 person. Means he should have the capability to motivate, organize, innovate, have the problem solving attitude, have the leadership quality also. He must have the influencing power also. And third, you can also say that a good people is the subject team. When you are working in a team member, you are suppose you are also working as a team member, then we have to trust each other. We have to trust each other. Basically, when there is a good team, some trust lacks or some trust is behind. And sometimes there is a communication gap also. So we should have a good communication among them also. Until unless we are not having a good communication between your team members, then the product or the person or the project on which we are working are the chances of failure. So what do you mean by product? As a software developer, you and other stakeholder must need to define product objectives and scopes in many cases, the activity begin as part of the system engineering or business process engineering and continue as a first step in the software requirement engineering. Now, as we have highlighted two words, there is objectives in the scope. Now, what do you mean by objective? Objective means to identify the overall goal for the product from the stakeholders, points stakeholder point of view, means to identify the overall goal for the product as per the perception of stakeholder, without considering how these goals will be achieved. Second, the scope means to identify the primary data, functions and the behaviors that characterize the product, and more important thing is that attempt to bound these characteristics in a quantitative manner. Means if you want to make a product, you are working on a product or you are working on a project, then these two things should be fulfilled. The third P that comes is the process. Now, we will study as a further here process. A process means a software process provides the framework from which a comprehensive plan for software development can be established. A small number of framework activities are applicable to all software projects regardless of their size and the complexity. We will further more elaborate the process in the next slides or in the next session. Now, the fourth key, that is the project. Now, basically, when we are moving towards some project, in a study it is seen that in a study done by a Kaper-John, and he studied between 1998 to 2004. He studied about 250 projects. He found that 25 projects were found successful in the schedule, in the cost and quality wise. 50 projects were delayed and 35% or about 175% were failed or they were not completed. So basically the project success rate for the present day software may have improved somehow. Our project failure rate remains much higher than it should be. So to avoid a project failure, a software project manager and the software engineer who build the product must avoid a set of common warning signs, understand the critical success factor that lead to the good project management, and to develop a common sense approach for planning, monitoring and controlling the project. So, you can see that for a project, the people are, for the success of a project, the people are behind the success. Means you can see that the four P's are interrelated to each other. Now, W5HH principle. Boeing suggests that an approach that addresses the project objectives, milestones, schedules, responsibilities, management, and technical approaches and required resources. We call it a W3HH principle. After a series of questions that lead to a definition of a key project characteristics and the resultant project plan. Now, why the system? So, in the W3HH principle, he had decided some questions. He said that these are some questions that if we are thinking of these questions,
सेकंड रोक के बोलते हैं, बोलने को से रोक रहे हैं।